Les batteries des véhicules électriques contiennent des matériaux rares, importants à recycler, tels que le lithium, le cobalt, le manganèse. Également, ces batteries au lithium contiennent des composants électriques, qui sont là pour gérer l'état de santé de la batterie, leur fonctionnement optimal. Ces composants peuvent aussi être récupérés. On se rend bien compte qu'il est important de recycler ces batteries, recyclage pour récupérer les matériaux, les composants électriques, mais aussi ces batteries peuvent être recyclées dans la mesure où elles peuvent être reconditionnées.
Did you know that advances in batteries are the main reason electric vehicles are now a viable alternative to internal combustion engine cars? The first prototype of the electric car was actually invented in the 1830s, decades before petrol cars came on the scene. They enjoyed popularity for a while, but back then, it was difficult to create lightweight batteries that could go long distances without needing a recharge. That, coupled with advances in petrol car engines and production, as well as the discovery of large oil reserves that made petrol widely available, led to the downfall of electric cars. Concerns about climate change and policies to reduce greenhouse gas emissions, such as the Paris Agreement and the European Green Deal, led to renewed public interest in electric cars. By this time, battery technology had undergone significant innovations, enabling electric cars to travel longer distances and rival the range of petrol-powered cars.
Right now, we have around 30 million electric cars on the streets worldwide. The volume of these batteries will be close to 100,000 tons by the end of 2030, and growing every year. In 8 or 10 years, the batteries in these cars will not fully die, but they will not be usable the same way.
So, what actually happens to the batteries then? Well, if the batteries are still in relatively good condition, they can come back from the dead through repurposing. However, if they are badly damaged or have too little capacity to be repurposed, then they are recycled.
Alors qu'elles ne peuvent plus être utilisées en véhicule électrique pour de la haute autonomie, ces batteries contiennent quelque chose comme 70 à 80% de leur capacité. Elles peuvent être employées pour des applications en stockage stationnaire, pour alimenter des bornes de stockage qui peuvent servir pour du cinéma, pour des hôpitaux, pour des écoles, pour des bornes de recharge de téléphones mobiles par exemple. Reconditionner les batteries de véhicules électriques est donc un élément important aujourd'hui pour des raisons économiques, mais aussi pour des raisons écologiques.
The steps to be taken before a battery can be repurposed or recycled, that's the process what we call battery reverse logistics. For electric vehicle batteries, it's a quite complicated process because there is very little information available to the user and to the owner of the vehicle. It's kind of like a black box. So most owners, if there's a problem with their battery, they rely on the warranty of the manufacturer to replace the faulty battery, or they try to sell their car when they're unhappy about the range on the second-hand market, so the entire vehicle. After warranty though, it's very difficult for the owner of the vehicle to do anything with the battery, as it's very hard to assess the residual value of it. Also for producers, since they don't have a lot of processes in place that encourage circular solutions such as repair or repurposing, their option by default is recycling. Luckily now that's supposed to change with the EU battery regulation into place, which encourages actually car manufacturers and battery manufacturers to look more into circular solutions.
There are still some concerns to be tackled. We need to safely discharge the battery to prevent electric shock in further processing. We have also to design reliable, fast and affordable tests, methods of characterizing the batteries to measure the state of the health of these batteries. We need also to consider the transport. We need to design and to count with specialized packaging systems to prevent, for example, accidents related to runaway of these batteries that can cause overheating and fires.
Thank you. when the battery pack reaches the recycled center. They usually get dismantled manually. That could represent some potential task to the workers. In our labs, we are developing machines and solutions to deal with that dangerous task, to help the humans to be more secure in that works. So, for example, you have that robot that is automatically opening and dismantling some battery packs. The idea is that it could recognize the battery pack that it's working with, no matter of the brand, if Tesla, Skoda or Renault.
Battery passport is a quite interesting concept. It's a unified way to track the history of a battery, where it has been, how it has been used, and what is the health status right now. We are working on it, and it will be mandatory quite soon. In February 2027, it will be mandatory for all batteries in the European Union to have this unified way, a QR code that you will be scanning and instantly get all this information. Everybody in this ecosystem is working somehow in silos. The market is fragmented. You have different companies, different research groups, working on the batteries, analyzing data, getting more and more information. What we are working on at Batteryverse is a common language. It's a way for all these partners, all these stakeholders to communicate with each other. We are building more or less place, a market for exchanging data. The idea is that in this ecosystem, using data spaces, using the digital passport, we want to support circular business models.
Creating a strong and resilient reverse logistics value chain will benefit both the economy and the environment, but it will take time and require more responsibility and cooperation. If we want to succeed, we must all work together. Industry, the research community, policymakers, and other key stakeholders.